Thanks for joining me again today for this video update. It's a big week in Parliament this week with a number of pieces of legislation that we are progressing. Of course, the GCSB legislation has its final reading in the House today. And I hope quite a few of you managed to watch the John Campbell interview with the Prime Minister, because I've had lots of feedback from people who finally understand exactly what the legislation is intended to do and what it's not intended to do. I'm really confident that New Zealand's national security will be much better as a result. And actually, the scrutiny over the GCSB is significantly improved over what's in the existing legislation that was drafted by the previous government in 2003. Another big piece of legislation is the Inquiries Bill. This is a piece of legislation that will assist the ministerial inquiry that's been set up by Ministers Nathan Guy and Nikki Kaye to look into the issues of the whey protein contamination. Obviously, our dairy industry is of vital importance to New Zealand. Literally, we manufacture millions and millions of products that are exported each year, and any food safety issue is going to be a concern. But the ministerial inquiry will make sure that the food safety systems are in place, are robust, and may recommend any changes. But I do think it's important to note that we, you know, primarily as a country, have a very, very strong record in this area. And although it's, you know, quite appropriate that we look into this, and obviously Fonterra is running their own inquiry to look at what happened with their company, it's important that we make sure we're constantly improving in this area, since such a large amount of our exports rely on it. The third piece of legislation that's another big one is the committee stage of the Resource Management Act. This is an area that we have substantially reformed already in the 5 years we've been in office, and there'll be further reforms that the Minister Amy Adams announced just over a week ago. It's one of those issues that really some of the underlying intent of it was good. I think in terms of the implementation of the 1990 legislation, perhaps some of it wasn't delivered as it was intended, which has meant that we've got the balance quite out of whack in terms of the protection of the environment and the need for development, often which creates jobs. So whether it's housing, whether it's businesses, whether it's a manufacturing plant, whether it's a dairy factory, whether it's a cycleway. The reality is that New Zealand as a country, like every other country in the world, needs development. But we've got to make sure that we have that balance in place in terms of protecting the environment as well, because that's such a vital part of our brand and as part of our reputation. So that's another piece of legislation we're progressing this week. Probably the area, the announcement last week, that is probably the closest to my own heart though, is that around the legislation we're introducing to protect vulnerable children. I've done a lot of forums and held a lot of meetings across the electorate on the topic of vulnerable children. And what I'll do is host another series of those meetings, because there's a lot of interest in the community in terms of what we're doing. And I want to make sure that you're really well informed about what the changes are. One of the very simple changes is making sure that anybody who's working with children is vetted. If there are any issues in their past, they will not be allowed to work with children, and that I think is one of the bare minimum things that we can do to protect our most vulnerable. But I'll organise some meetings. I'd love you to come along and get the most recent up-to-date information about the Children's Action Plan and what this government's doing to protect our most vulnerable children. Thanks for joining me, and I'll catch you next week.